Remember that time a rocket was struck by lightning in flight? You probably don't, so I'm gonna tell you about it. Hey everyone, Amy with you on D News today, and we're doing this really fun thing for the show's fourth birthday. We're all updating our first episodes! So all that was left for Apollo 11 to do was actually touch down on the moon. So yeah, mine was a recap of Apollo 11, and there's not much new on Apollo 11 because, well, history. So you can't really revisit it. But you could say that Apollo 12 revisited Apollo 11 by returning to the moon, and that was actually a pretty electrifying mission. As the second lunar landing mission, Apollo 12 was tasked with doing a little bit more than just getting to the moon. One of the goals was for the crew to make a pinpoint landing on the moon's ocean of storms so Pete Conrad and Al Bean could walk over and recover pieces of the Surveyor 3 probe that had landed there almost 3 years earlier. And they nailed it! The scoop from Surveyor 3 was recovered and is on display at the Visitor Center at JPL in Pasadena. But they almost didn't bring it back. In fact, they almost didn't make it to the moon at all. The morning of Friday, November 14th, 1969, was a very cloudy one at the Kennedy Space Center, but nonetheless, the Saturn V's rocket launch was perfect. Then, 37 seconds after leaving the launch pad, the crew saw a flash and felt a shudder. At the same time, their headsets filled with static, and all the displays in the command module and mission control suddenly displayed gibberish. Then came the warning lights and alarms. It looked like the spacecraft's power system was so badly damaged it was running on batteries, which meant the crew was in a dying spacecraft that had been forcibly separated from the rocket by the launch abort system. They would be coming straight home. They wouldn't even go into orbit. But the crew hadn't felt the jolt of a launch abort, and they could still feel the steady acceleration of the rocket. So contrary to their gibberish data, they instinctively knew they were still riding a functioning Saturn V. On the ground, meanwhile, observers knew exactly what was going on. They saw not one, but two lightning strikes ride the rocket's contrail all the way down to strike near the launch pad. Flying through the clouds, the Saturn V had become a lightning rod, generating electricity by friction. But this didn't help NASA flight controllers fix the fact that they'd lost all data from Apollo 12. One guy did know how to fix the problem, though, an engineer named John Aaron. He'd seen the same gibberish data pattern during a test when a controller had dropped the simulated spacecraft's power below normal levels. The low power had upset the signal conditioning equipment, a box of electronics that translates information from sensors into data on displays. So that's why all the data displayed went haywire but didn't disappear. And he'd learned from that test that the SCE would be tripped up by low voltage in the normal setting, but in the auxiliary setting could work in a low voltage situation. And so he passed on the command to Flight Director Jerry Griffin, try SCE to aux, and Griffin had no idea what he was talking about, and neither did Capcom Jerry Carr, and the crew didn't get it either. When they got the call to turn SCE to auxiliary, Pete Conrad's reaction was, "What the hell is that?" But Al Bean somehow knew where that switch was. He flipped it, and all the data came back beautifully. The crew laughed about it all the way into orbit and went on to fly a successful mission. So what did NASA do to stop another lightning strike giving everyone involved in a launch a heart attack? Well, because lightning struck the Saturn V in flight, they couldn't exactly ground it. And besides, Apollo 12's launch really just proved that the Saturn V was a hardy machine. But the agency did include lightning protection for its next generation spacecraft, the Space Shuttle, when it was on the launch pad. A mast was installed on top of the service structure so any lightning would be diverted down wires and away from the spacecraft. Because really, you can't do anything about a rocket turning into a lightning rod, but not launch it through a storm. You just gotta build your rockets to have fail-safes to stop a lightning rod situation from turning disastrous. Apollo 12 was the mission of deep space porn, questionable tuna, and possible hypnosis to prevent cursing on the moon. I've got loads of Apollo 12 videos over on my channel, Vintage Space, so come learn about the weird with me. And if you want to learn all about Apollo 11, check out my first ever D News video. Tell us your favorite moon moments in the comments below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe right here for a new episode of D News every day of the week.